Hi guys, Chuffy here. First time in front of the camera on my own channel. At the end of this short video will be a battle report from Templar Crusades. It's the Apoc battle I took place in on Saturday just gone. I'd like to make a mention to a few people this weekend. I'd like to mention Fulgrim, Triss, Lisa, Girl Painting 2010, and Don, my niece Augustus Calgar. Big thank you to all of you and the kids, Cameron, Bradley and Vicky, for yesterday when I went round for basically paying a visit, seeing how the guys are and have a chat. And they were doing a 6th edition battle report between Emperor's Children and Lunar Wolves. That'll come up at some point soon. Once Don's edited it all, I'd like to say a big thank you to all of you for the cake and all and the card and everything. It surprised me. Thanks very much, guys. Much appreciated. I'd also like to thank Templar Crusade. On Saturday this weekend, hosted a big Apoc battle, which you'll see in the battle report at the end of this vid. I'd like to say thanks to him. I'd like to say thanks to Jamie, Dell and Matthew for playing the Harud. You bastards. They hurt, and they hurt a lot. And you'll see in the battle report. I'd also like to thank all my all the players that played with us. So you've got the Black Legion Braska, you've got Rich, you've got Jamie Jackson, Kev Case, we all did really well. We did struggle. It was a hard... Oh, yeah, sorry, and Princess, I forgot, as Brian puts it. Yeah, we had a nice hard fight, probably one of the hardest fights that I've had to do in 40k for a long time. I think we got a little bit bottlenecked, but you'll see in the battle report. And it was a very hot, sweaty day, and that's all I will say about that one. I'd like to say I've got a few things that are coming up. I've got, I'll do an unboxing on this actually. I don't normally do unboxings. But this is one of the presents I got this weekend, which is the Space Marine Mark IV Command characters. They are actually very detailed, but there's one little problem with them, which they actually have on the website. So I'll go through that on the unboxing. I'm going to phone Forge World and have a chat with them and see what the crack is. But I'll explain all that in the other vid. And I've got a few other bits and pieces. I got the new second edition of the Model Masterclass Imperial Armour book. I have a Titan to paint and build and all that lot at some point. That'll be a Warhound Lucius pattern. Unfortunately, I've been threatened by the wife. I must finish her Hierophant, building it anyway, before I'm allowed to even start mine. So that's been in the works for a little while, so I shall actually work on that now. I've got a bit of time now before I do any more of the big games. I think I've got an Apoc game in November coming, which is where I'll play my Necrons. So I've got a few Necrons to paint and build, to say the least. I've also got a little treat. Some Firestorm Armada coming. This is the Solarian Dreadnought. So I've got that to paint up. I'm going to try and finish that fleet and do a battle report with a friend of mine. I've got to talk him into it yet, but he's got the Dindrinzi fleet, I think it is, or it's called something like that, so that'll be coming up on the channel soon. So this is kind of like a bit of an update type stuff. I can't think of anything else off the top of my head, but I'd like to thank everyone for this weekend. It's been great. I really have enjoyed it. It beats having to work at Greenfields, which I had to last year, and considering it all got flooded and closed this weekend, I'm glad I didn't work there this weekend. Please comment, rate and subscribe. I hope you enjoy the battle report at the end of this vid. And I'll be catching you all in the next one. Take care.
Let's make models with Templars Crusade. Okay, guys. Hi, guys. How you doing? Here we are. We're at the final game with the Harad. Some people here have played Harad. Put your hands up who's played Harad before. Yeah. And you hate them. Okay, yes. So what have we got here? Today we've got Jamie.
Hello.
What are you playing? Who are you?
I'm playing Ferris Manus and I'm Iron Hands.
Nice. Rich?
I'm playing Forex, Captain Forex, the Iron Warriors.
Nice. Black Legion Brasker.
Hurt Your Robo and the Iron Warriors.
Chuffy.
Captain Fenelon and the Salamanders.
Kev Case.
Vulcan and the Salamanders.
Princess Alan.
Major Sam Shadrach and the Iron Hands.
Fantastic, so I had to throw one in there. Okay, and your opponents are?
Hello, Jamie again with the Harad.
ATX Shadow Angel, Harad.
And Matt playing the evil Harad again.
And I'm not playing, I'm the impartial judge. Okay, that's enough. Okay, so what we've got here today is a fantastic display of well-painted miniatures on this side of the table. And as we move over there to the silver and the yellows and the blacks, fantastic. That Fellblade. Finish, Jamie, do you want to finish calling people now? Thank you very much. Right, so over there we've got a fantastic Iron Warriors, we've got the Iron Warriors over there, we've even got the Iron Hands, we've got the Salamanders breaking it all up with their green, and we've got more of the Iron Hands over here as well. With behind them, were they? Iron Warriors?
They're all
Iron Hands over there. There is a display of Mortis galore mixed with tons of Predators, lots of Rhinos and some Spartans. And that big beauty in the back, which I think looks fantastic. You've done a really great job of that.
Thank you.
Okay, so what's their mission? It's into the nest, as described earlier on this morning when I put the video up. That's somebody else's phone going off. You would have thought everybody would have turned their phones off, wouldn't you? But they haven't. How impolite. Okay, so what have we got? We've got the Harad over here. Now, there's a lot of Harad in reserves. I talked about the Queen being over there. They've got to get into this city. There's objectives here. Objectives there, but if you watch this previous video that has just popped up, and it should be about now or yesterday morning at 10:30, don't reach for your computer, you're not watching it. No, don't watch it.
I'm not gonna watch it.
Good. Right, so basically it's gonna be an immense game, so we're gonna roll for now to see who gets the first turn. Chuffy, you can roll for your side, you're running for your side. Please get a dice.
I always fail.
No pressure.
Green dice.
There you go. A dice. Oh, you got your own?
Okay, this is for this reason.
This is the only time you can mould it in the table. So, green is two.
I always fail. Yes.
So the Space Marines go first. Fantastic. I will see you at the end of turn one.
Cheers, Matt.
For the Space Marines and, of course, the Harad. Take care. Okay, guys, here we are. It's the end of turn one for the Space Marines, and it's the end of turn one for the Harad. Black Legion Brasker is going to speak for the Space Marines and explain to us what's gone on.
Okay, so Chuffy and Matt rolled first turn. We got it, so we've pushed forward with everything we've got. Pretty much all the vehicles went 12 inches forwards, infantry following them. Not quite in range of tank shock yet. That's the famous manoeuvre. We're going to save that till next turn. We had two Dreadnoughts come down, a Salamanders and Iron Warriors one over there.
And that's just by the tunnel entrance?
Yes, indeed. So they've got mobs and took part in several close combats. I think one's dead and one's still alive, which
Fantastic.
Is always good. We had a Devastator squad or a tactical squad?
Devastator
squad, a pinpoint dropped pod right on top of the landing pad to give us some support.
And there's Chuffy, what do you call it?
Balls deep.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
So we opened fire. We took some big chunks out of the big unit of Nocturnes over there.
Yeah.
We dropped an orbital bombardment and wiped out most of the unit of Nocturnes which were fleeing over there. We took a nice big chunk out of these guys. The Fellblade blew nice big holes out of the stuff that was over here.
And by the way, we're all fighting. This is night fighting as
yes,
well,
indeed.
So using spotlights to light everything up, and then you're all firing onto those positions.
Yes, indeed. You have to imagine it's complete pitch black, just strobe lighting from the weapons, beams of spotlights flashing across the battlefield, and lots of screaming and shouting and bad language.
It's poetically done.
Thank you very much. The only assaults we had were over there.
Yeah.
And that was the end of our turn, and we passed it over to the Harad.
Okay, so I'm going to wander over now to Matt, and he's going to explain to us what the Hrud have done. So go for it, Matt.
Okay, so in typical Hrud fashion, we swarmed. Pretty much everything's moved forward apart from a couple of squads that are just lurking behind buildings just to keep cover. The Nocturnes over here got the pants shot off them in the turn, charged up and said, "Die, Vulcan!" and failed to wound Vulcan because their shooting's not very good. We've got our kind of bio tanks, a couple down here that shot at the Land Raider Proteus of the Iron Hands, managed to blow it up. And then one of them charged in and got a servo harness to the face for his troubles, so that wasn't particularly good. We had Purebloods charge in and wreck that rhino there, and we had lots of shooting going on, and Land Raiders have been immobilised and
whatnot. Let's just take a moment to look at the burning wreck.
Which, when the fan is on, you have said, blows in the wind.
It's rather nice. Very pretty. Okay, let's carry on.
Down here, we lost a squad of Purebloods into the combat with the YMCA-ing...
What's that character called?
Contemptor.
Promodon.
Lightning Clawed Contemptor. First turn, nothing happened. Second turn, he killed us and chased us off the board. And then we had a whole host of Lance Spire into Chuffy's poor Contemptor here that then died.
It did its job.
It did kill Tenkwa, but there's also a drop pod missing from there as well.
Yeah, we shot that with lances and blew that up as well. So
that's fantastic. Eventually, it took a lot of fire, didn't it?
It did indeed.
Okay, so that's the end of turn one. We're now going to move to the Space Marines turn two. I will see you at the end of turn two for the Hrud as well. Take care, guys. Okay, guys, here we are. It's the second round. It's been titanic in the sense that there's been a lot destroyed and there's some lots of clear spaces. So I'm going to start off over here with the Space Marine players. They're going to tell me what's happened in their games.
Okay, so we started with our first tank shock. So the tank's rumbling over the Hrud and doing absolutely naff all. They're not failing any leadership tests. The entire battlefield, the Iron Warriors moving forward here, the Iron Hands, Iron Warriors and Salamanders moving forward there, apart from Chuffy's immobilised Land Raider. Thank you, Chuffy.
Anytime, mate.
The Flyers, the Flyers came on, swooped across the city, lashing some fire into some Purebloods that were down here.
That's fantastic.
What
about the guys on the top? Have they done anything?
They just killed one Nocturne.
Well, to tidy up another 5 points.
One. Yeah. It took four multi-melters. All the bolters failed.
Well, that's 5 points that you didn't have. That's why I'm looking
at it. It is. Well done. Okay, so we charged in. Vulcan charged in. The Iron Hands charged in.
Capturing that objective.
Capturing the objective and wiping out. I think we wiped out four of the larger creatures this turn. The Predators. With Vulcan, with Alan's character over there. Was it Jamie's? What's your character, Jamie?
That was Helmek.
Helmek over there killed one. There were two over here that got taken down by Iron Warrior shooting. The Fellblade blew another big hole out the back of some stuff here. And the Dreadnought, a load of Dreadnoughts came on over there for the Iron Hands.
We'll go around there and have a little look. So all in all, it's been quite cool for the Space Marines. They've managed to take out quite a bit because I'm tallying up the scores. The score's pretty good at the moment. It could be better, and it will be better. It will, because it's only the second turn. You've got plenty of time to go yet. You've wiped out quite a bit, so I'm going to move over here with the Hrud player now, and he's the spokesman. This is our friend, him. Okay, let's go. What's happened?
Okay, so the squad Helmek, did you say?
Helmek, yeah.
Helmek that was there got shot at by Tanqua and the Purebloods and got wiped out. We had lots of stuff die down here to Alan's brilliant Might of the Ancients. Three Dreadnoughts coming on and just took them apart, absolutely just butchered them. Over there, our kind of bio tank Carnifex-y thing did very, very little and got absolutely nothing. This squad of Terminators here are immortal. They took so many shots from the squads of Warriors and Purebloods there and survived everything. And we had a couple more. We had a couple of friends turn up. We had 50 Nocturnes down there, 100 shots firing into the Iron Warriors and did one wound. but Tiny's turned up.
So basically, the ground gave way, the building collapsed, and out popped this giant creature we're calling the Hrud Colossus. And it shot at...
Ferris,
and did one wound.
One wound.
That's not too bad. So Ferris is up for it now. He's very angry, and he's just there. So I'm going to see the end of turn three for the Space Marines and the Hrud players, and I'm expecting a lot of pain. A lot of pain. Speaking anyway. Bye. Okay, so that's the end of turn three for both groups. It's been a massive evil battle, filled with ups and downs. I think you'll agree. So Black Legion Braska is going to lead us through it. Go for it.
Okay, so really our advance kind of started to falter around this massive, huge, honking thing that popped out of the ground. So we kind of circled round, we brought a Vendetta on and some more Terminators, but the focus was on this side of the board to try and take this out. We shot las cannons, we shot thunderfires, we shot more las cannons, assault cannons. We got it down to one wound with some assaulting from Ferris Manus, but it still didn't die, and we'll come to that probably in the heroic turn. The 50 Nocturnes that were here got tank shot twice and still failed to fail their leadership test. And then got shot with that mortise and killed several and they ran off, which is great.
And now you're sitting on top of the tunnel. So
I am, I'm sitting on top of that tunnel so they can't come out anymore. The flyers continue to zoom across the battlefield, disgorging Terminators into the heart of the Horde over here, and the Dreadnoughts continue their march along the flank. I accidentally blew one up with a scheduled bombardment. It's all planning for us, Devan, it's fine. Then the rest of these guys kept piling forward. Percharabo is leading the charge down the middle in his Land Raider, hoping to back the Terminators up because they're suffering quite a bit. That was about it. Have I missed anything? I don't think I have.
No, you've done everything. Right, so we're going to move over now to the Harad. Matt, lead us through it.
Okay, so probably the biggest arrival is Tiny's brother Teeny turned up.
Well done. Very good.
He turned up, did some shooting, which was altogether not very effective. We had a squad of Pure Bloods that got wiped out there by this amazing Iron Hands Command Squad who have just been slapping Pure Bloods around left, right, right and centre.
Definitely.
We've had a couple more Gribblies come out of our holes. So most of the craters that you guys can see across here are bug holes. Things have been coming out of them and... there's lots of tanks parked all over them. We can't really come out of the holes at the moment.
So nothing can come out.
So the few that were there, people have popped up and taken a few pot shots with the lances, not really done very much. I did shoot at the rhino in the middle that you can see there, to which Chuffy told me after resolving hits that it was in fact immobilized and empty. So it was altogether a wasted series of shots. Down here, really unfortunate rolls for Chuffy and his Pyre Guard Terminators, and they've lost Fire Drake. Terminators. They've lost 8 of their number to a combined assault of warriors and pure bloods.
Yeah.
There's a lot of other Terminators and Percharabo turning up to say. I think they're going to be reinforced sometime soon. Nice. We've got more bugs obviously in the nest board down here that are starting to make their way forward. They're fed up of how long these humans have been on the planet.
And also, I think the Salamanders, the Primarch for the Salamanders, Kev, that's your Primarch. He's actually wiped out an entire unit, hasn't he?
Pretty much. Took out a prime and about half a unit just on his own.
Fantastic. And now they're moving forward to join into the fray. He's going to take that out. I know it. I know what he's like.
Don't forget we regenerated.
So we regenerated wounds there.
So he got knocked down to 1, regenerated back up to 6, and now he's been taken back down to 3. Ferris Manus is climbed on his head and beating him to death with his hammer.
I've got to say, that's been really close with Ferris Manus.
Yeah.
That was absolutely amazing bit of the battle. I mean, that would, for me, that's got to be the sort of starting point where things are starting to change now. So we're going to see what's going to happen in turn 4. I will see you after the Space Marines and after the Harad, and we're hoping that the big Gribbly starts to drop. I'll see you guys later. Okay guys, welcome back. It's the end of turn 4 for both parties. Black Legion Braska, lead us through it.
Right, okay. So once again, a massive push up through the middle with armour racing down the roads. Percharabo came and jumped out and helping out the Salamanders Terminators here. Saying that, we've also finally made the entrance to the cave, which is filled with Chitinous Horrible Death. We're completely bogged down in there. We've had, through a load of firepower, everything inside of this section of the board firing. Down went the Bio-Titan or
that's
non-Bio-Titan.
Also, Ferris Manus gave a good whack on that.
Yeah, gave it a good smack in the face, and then a last cannon predator from the Iron Hands finished it off.
It was from the Iron Hands, wasn't it? Yeah.
So also we concentrated fire on all the things that were coming out behind us.
Yeah.
And we shot them all down. One of them got tank shot off the board.
Yes, they did. I remember watching that happen. So all in all, it was a great round. There was some serious fighting going on. The Marines are starting to push into the nest now, and they're also holding objective areas there and over there, and they've still got that objective there. But what's going on with the Harad?
Not a lot. Our turns are quite quick. There's not much left. Tiny, upset that Tiny died, charged into Vulcan and his Pyre Guard. And even though the Pyre Guard are absolutely nails, they're wounding on sixes, and so nothing happened there. I think I did one wound that he did nothing. Other than that, the remaining warriors and things we've gone have been charging into Forex and his Terminators. Managed to whittle all them down to just Forex, so he's kind of holding the entrance to the Harad nest on his own there. But everything's starting to swarm on round. But we're looking a bit thin on the ground. There's still quite a lot of green and black and yellow and silver on the board, and not much of us.
So it's going quite well. I think all in all, it's been a fantastic game so far. We're now going to move into turn five. And I'll see you at the end of turn five for the Space Marines and the Harad. Take care. Hi guys, so here we are. It's the end of turn five for both sides. Now we've rolled the dice to see whether this mission carries on, and it does carry on. So we've got another turn in play. So we'll be moving on to turn six after this. I've got to say, it's a very heated battle. It's been tough for these guys because they're up against a force that is absolutely deadly in numbers. And they've had it hard because obviously the Colossals have been really thumping hard. So what we're going to do is we're going to start off with Black Legion Braska, and he's going to explain to us what's gone on.
Okay, so once again, a very powerful drive at the middle of the table. The Iron Warriors cleared off their objective, sent him running, but he's come back. But that left us open to play our master card, which was the strategic redeployment. So all the Iron Warriors over here shifted all the way over there, right to the front of the cave mouth. We've got the Devastators, we've got the Fellblade, we've got the Mortises, everything's up there ready to make this final Death or Glory push onto the Queen. The Iron Warriors and Salamanders finally smashed their way through the Warriors that were here. The stupid Harud character that took me another turn to kill that I had in my first game against the Harud, Perturabo, smashed him in the face with a big hammer, and we cleared that. All the Iron Warriors, or pretty much all the Iron Warriors, have died inside the tunnel system, but that's cleared us up for some charges, some tank shocks, and hopefully bashing our way through into the middle.
Yep.
Teeny over there has taken melter shots, las cannon bolts, bolt shots, heavy bolt shots, assault cannon shots, rocket, everything has just bounced off him. He won't bloody die.
Oh, and a ram.
And a ram, a strength 17 ram to the face, and still didn't die. So at the moment, he lost. He was down to three wounds. Then Templar Crusader one rolled for the wounds to come back and got four more wounds back. Yeah, so he's up to seven. He's joyous.
He just took a couple more wounds.
Which is a hurried turn, which is over to Matt for.
So basically, also we've allowed the ram to attack the creature. Normally you can't. Just so people know that. But we're allowing it in this game for them to do that because it's cool. A big monstrous creature and it looks really cool. Right, so let's go over to Matt.
Cool, so we'll start with Teeny. Like they say, everything got like completely thwacked at him. He's turned around, he's hacked some things down. The Legion Dreadnought's now dead. Charged into Vulcan and his command squad, did a couple of wounds on there and took off one of the other Salamanders, Captain Command guys. Did he
wounded
not?
In my turn.
Yeah, we wounded it back in his turn. He's down to six wounds now, having been down and up all over the place. He's done a couple of glancing hits as well on the big Iron Warriors tank cluster in the middle as well. And then we've had more reserves turn up, so we've got a squad of purebloods coming out the hole that Teeny made as he came up. We've got another one of our bio tank things, I think, over there, and a load of warriors have turned up. We've got another big squad of nocturnes down the far end, and we killed Forex, and also the special contemptor with his hands in the air like he just
Poppadom.
Didn't care.
Poppadom.
So we've got a big squad of kind of warriors and purebloods in there ready to come through
nicely though.
Yeah,
there's two land speeders in there for some reason. We're not going to go on about it.
Moral victory.
Not a moral victory.
We've got a mouse problem. There's a Carnifex getting rid of it.
No, exactly. And also, they've got a control system problem, haven't they? They actually wanted to go that way, but they ended up that way for some reason. So, what can I say? It just went wrong. But all in all, it's looking good. Also, I've got to say, obviously, you would turn around and normally wouldn't be having reinforcements turning up now, but for the story wise and fluff, we're allowing for reinforcements to come in and also attack, so it gives them extra points to fight and kill off. Okay, so this has turned out really, really well so far. It's a real mess that everything is all over the place. There's bad guys over there, there's bad guys down there, there's Marines all over here, Marines up there. So now it's the big push into the nest itself, and I'm hoping that they can earn some decent points from this now. So I'm going to see you at the end of turn six for the Space Marines and the Harad. Take care. Okay, guys, so here we are. It's been a adventure. I mean, it has been an adventure. I've been tallying up the points as well. So we're just going to discuss how it went. And we're going to start off with Black Legion Brasco. Lead us on our journey, please.
Okay, so the push continued into the tunnel. The Iron Warriors, the Salamanders battling through the tunnels, the strobing, gun flashes, the screeching of the hood as they smashed apart, exploding rhinos. It all went on there. The Iron Warriors backed them up. They tried to get the Queen in their sights, but they discovered she had chameleonic cloaking all around her, so they couldn't draw beadness. They turned their fire on. Teeny, along with the Salamanders and the Iron Hands, punishing barrages from the firing lines until finally Vulcan stepped forward and sliced its head off with his massive glaive, and the second Goliath went down. So, cleaning up really, the Iron Warriors finished off these guys here. We took a couple of pot shots at the last guy, last couple of large creatures that are on this section of the board. One of them died, one of them is still alive.
Yeah.
Wasn't a great deal else we could do.
Apart from someone flying a
bit
downtown.
Oh yeah, well I'm going to get to that. We're going to talk about this now. This is the best moment. We have this thing called Bloody Call. And it's not a rule within the game, but if you can roll a six on a dice, this is, we always allow this for special manoeuvres, and it just earns you extra points in the game. So what happened was, is Manus Faris is in his, he jumps into a, sorry, what's his name?
Ferris Manus,
it's been a long, long day. He jumps into a Valkyrie or Vendetta, I can't remember what it's called, and they fly basically across here. They get to this point here, and I said, if you can roll a six, I'll allow you to smash your way through the tunnel, but your wings get ripped off, but you hit every single thing in the tunnel, and then it stops just there. So, lucky enough, Alan, being a very brave man, he said, okay, I'm going to give it a go. Now, we allow this to give extra points, and because it makes the game a lot more cinematic and a lot more fun. So he rolled a six, and he hit everything on his way in. Lucky enough, the Terminator survived it. There was a Rhino there. That survived it. I think it just took a glancing hit, maybe destroyed a weapon of some sort. I don't know. But I think I'm right there. A load of Nocturnes and Warriors were killed as this thing came to a stop. And then Ferris Manus jumped out and stood in front of the Queen. And I've got to say, it's been titanic. So why don't you lead us on the rest of this journey?
All right, cool. So we'll start of the big fight. So the Queen wasn't content to obviously sit in her den. Her big children, the Bio Titan Groblies, have all been killed. So she came out. She saw this interloper in her cave, charged him down, has managed to do no wounds to him. Ferris Manus has just dropped his hammer, I mean, wailing into her, silver fist blazing, and has taken four of her six wounds off her.
Fantastic.
She's only got two wounds left. And Santerre has just stepped past her. That's all happening in a challenge, new sixth third challenge rules. Santerre has just stepped past and killed two of her bodyguard, two of the kind of bigger purebloods that we've got.
Fantastic.
Other than that, we've
taken out a flyer that's there.
Taken out the skimmer. The moral victory skimmer is no longer very moral. It's a bloody wreck on the floor.
That's been wiped out. Everything else has moved forward. There's been a fight over here with the Iron Warriors.
Yeah, killed a load of Iron Warriors and shooting, then charged in. I was surprised those two actually survived. But those are two of the last tactical squad of the Iron Warriors.
Terminators.
One Terminator left after three of his brethren got killed by all the Warriors in there. So inside the nest, there's a lot of fighting, and there's a couple of little bits of swarms just outside. These guys did nothing against the Dreadnought, couldn't quite glance it to death. But as you can see, there's loads of vehicles parked all over our bog holes. So
yeah,
we're not coming out of there.
And there was a battle down here. All that's been wiped out as well.
Yeah, there was 50 Nocturnes, and then the Salamanders introduced them to some good old high-fashioned...
Yeah, burning death, flaming death. So, the guys are wondering whether it goes to another turn. And I have to say, I'm sorry, but there is another turn because I rolled it secretly. I rolled a six. So you're still in the game, and we're going to roll on to turn six, and I will see you after turn six. Okay, guys, welcome back. It's the end of turn six. It's the final part of the game. It will not be carrying on. The objectives have been met, and I've got to say, it was fantastic. So I'm here with Black Legion Brasco. Lead us through it, matey.
So end of turn seven.
Turn 7, yeah, it was, wasn't it? Yeah.
So the drive, the push continued, so all the vehicles and infantry kept pushing into the tunnel. We pushed forward into the Pure Bloods that were there, the Iron Warriors still holding off the Warriors there. We were picking off the few units that were left around, so the Predators, the Pure Bloods, they all got taken down, so with the final push into the nest. Ferris dueling with the Queen, knocked her down to one wound, it was all very close. Santander over there slaughtered the last of the bodyguards, so it was the final kind of duel with the bodyguard and all the army rushing up to kind of meet up with him, and then we went into the hurried turn.
And that was fantastic. I mean, I've got to say, the Space Marine players have played the hardest game I've seen so far in the Apocalypse campaign. Not going to say that the Mega Arachnids is going to be just as hard as Planet Murder, because we don't know yet, but all I'm going to say is they played a really hard, hard game, and I'm taking my hat off to them. So, Matt, lead us through it.
Cool. So, just down here, we've got the Iron Hands Command Squad and the Dreadnought just finished off the last squad of Pure Blood. They were outside of the nest, so outside of the nest was totally secure. I'm really surprised that those Marines still survived in that last little fight against the Warriors. We had a couple of little bits and pieces here with just people milling around, but no one really cares about that, because all we're interested in is the big fight. And Ferris Manus, having worked so hard to reduce this thing down to one wound, with rerolls to hit, rerolls to wound, couldn't deal the last blow. So he stood there grappling with it, and Santander, having finished off the last one, just comes and slides the lightning claw in from behind and just kills it. So they're in a smoke-filled, burnt-out wreck of a vendetta-filled cavern with a dead Spider Queen, and they done it.
A dead Harad Queen. The big Tinies, the Colossals have been wiped out, so it's been a fantastic game. Okay, so I'm just going to go around the table quickly. Best part for you?
It's got to be the Titans coming up, scared the crap into everyone, basically. Really nice cinematic idea.
Fantastic. What about you, matey?
Just a really cool idea of breaking through that front line of road and having the spearhead of armour charging down the road. That's really cool.
That was nice. Okay, Buddha, go on.
For me, it's got to be the moral victory for the Land Speeders.
Which is, do you want to just tell us what that moral victory
they
was?
They paved the way and they flew all the way to the bomb, but then they couldn't quite arm it because they were in Land Speeders. So they went and shot the Queen and got hit by a Vendetta, and that was it. So they tried really hard, but...
Yeah, they did really well. Chuffy, what was the highlight for you?
Ass ramming the Titan.
That was really good.
I enjoyed that time.
With your... Tell us what you did it with.
Oh, the Cestus Ram.
There you go, fantastic. And that was the highlight for you for that whole game.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, Gordon.
Opened the head off with Vulcan, off the Titan.
Nice. So. Decapitating the Colossal.
Yeah, decapitated it. I've been there for about 3 turns, so...
Nicely done. Dale.
There were so many cool moments in that game, but for me it has to be the Vendetta crashing through that tunnel.
Yeah,
that was just awesome.
That was cool,
that
wasn't it?
Proper awesome.
That was really cool. Okay, mate, go on, Alan.
I've got to agree with Dale. The throwing the Vendetta down the tunnel, just admittedly wiping everything, including loyalists, out as well. nothing was left at the end of it, so that would be mine as well, I think.
Fantastic. Big man, I know what you're going to say. Come on, tell us the highlight.
Fighting the Queen at the end, yeah. That was good.
That is stepping
out. My heart was a little bit like that at the end.
But you wiped it out.
With Santander.
Yeah, oh yes. And you, big man.
I just like the idea of Ferris Manus getting in the Vendetta when it was over the other side of the board and flying across, because he's so big, you could just see him hanging out going, "Come on, we can do it! There's a hole! Let's go!"
Well, all in all, it was a fantastic game and everybody deserves a big pat on the back. But also, it's a friend of ours' birthday tomorrow, so everybody wish Chuffy happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
He's going to be 24 again. Okay, then. So listen, you guys take care. The next big mission is in October, and it's Space Marines versus the Mega Arachnids on Planet Murder. So you look out for the Blood Angels, the Lunar Wolves, and also the Emperor's Children. It's going to be a fantastic game. I'll see you guys later. Take care.